Hi, and welcome to Concepts for Thinking. Today we're going to be talking about, or I'm going to be talking about, spurious correlation. So spurious means false or fake, and correlation means events that are co-occurring together. And a spurious correlation therefore translates into false correlation, but in what sense false? Correlations happen all the time, events happen together. And if they consistently happen together, humans tend to make the inference that there's a causal relation. We, I snap my fingers and I assume that this motion that I'm making is contributing causally to the sound that I'm hearing. And a lot of times that assumption is good, but sometimes the assumption is bad. For instance, there's a correlation between shark attacks and ice cream sales. And of course, if you think about it for a little while, you can understand that, you know, there's actually a third variable that's accounting for both of these variables. Ice cream sales rise when it gets hot out. And of course, when it's hot out, people go in the ocean more and are more likely to be killed by sharks. So there's no causal relationship between shark attacks and ice cream sales. No direct causal link, but they are correlated events. And so that would be called a spurious correlation. And of course, that example is really obvious. Most people aren't walking around thinking that buying ice cream is, you know, causing someone to be eaten by a shark. But some correlations are harder to understand. We assume they're causal and they're just not. So if you guys remember, and it's still happening, but I'd say like a decade ago, there were all these findings coming out in from neuroscience where people were, the headlines, you know, big sexy headlines were saying, this brain region is doing this, you know, because we've used fMRI, brain imaging, to see that this brain area is active when the person is doing this task. And, you know, I think like most people or many people, I just assumed that was, you know, if you look at the brain and you see this activity, then you're seeing a causal relation. And it wasn't until I joined a neuroscience lab and worked there for several years that I understood that fMRI data in neuroscience are purely correlational, which means that they might indicate causality, but they might not. So, I mean, to go back to the snapping example, let's say we were scanning my brain and we didn't know anything about brains. And we were trying to figure out what parts of the brain were involved in singing. And so you put me in a scanner and I'm supposed to be singing. And then you looked at the brain and you looked at regions that were lighting up when I was singing. But suppose also that I just happen to have the habit of snapping whenever I sing. Well, there's gonna be part of the cortex that's gonna light up because of the snapping. And that's gonna show up because I'm singing, but it's just a spurious correlation. So that's what a spurious correlation is. It's when you have a correlation and you might think it's causal, but it's really not. And that's important because in our society, well, in general, in human nature, we're constantly seeing connections, meaningful connections that don't exist. So spurious correlation is one of those connections. But, you know, have you ever noticed that when you buy a car, suddenly you start seeing that model everywhere? Or I had a friend that started seeing the number 1104 everywhere, and she told our group of friends, and we all started seeing the number 1104. Of course, we weren't actually seeing it more, we were just noticing it more. But the human mind, our minds, tended to attribute meaning to that and to see meaning in this coincidence. And that's a totally benign example, but in our society, we're constantly being encountering forces that are trying to persuade us to believe things. And oftentimes the evidence used is correlational and it's presented as if it's this really strong evidence of, you know, whatever health fad is going on or political opinion that someone's trying to persuade you of. So it's really important to be able to know the distinction between correlation and causation. That's why scientists repeat the phrase over and over, correlation is not causation. It doesn't mean that a correlation is not indicating causation. It just means that it doesn't necessarily indicate causation. You have to do more investigation in order to know for sure. So that's my spiel on spurious correlations, and I hope it was helpful. Take care.